The early 2000s was a fantastic time. For my life and for skateboarding, Bam Margera was huge, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater games had video games in a chokehold, and everybody wanted to be a skateboarder. I started skateboarding 20 years ago. Oh my god, that makes me officially old. I'll start out by saying, when I was a kid, I absolutely loved Grind. It was the greatest movie ever. It was a full-blown movie about skateboarding. That's like a movie about video games in today's day and age. The movie literally shaped my childhood. I watched this movie constantly. I watched it on demand almost every single day. And then my dad got it for me on DVD, and I swear to God, I never didn't watch it. To this day, I could quote the movie from start to finish. That's how much I watched it as a kid. It's the greatest movie ever. I'm super stoked for it. But listen, I'm not here to review the movie. I'm here to rewatch the movie as an adult and see what happens. It literally kicked to the camera, and I've never noticed that before. That's amazing. You know, it's important to note that all the skating is filmed from the waist down. Obviously, because the actors can't skateboard. But that's painfully obvious when you see the actors carry around the skateboards. But hey, who am I to judge, man? They can carry it any way they want. Wait, hang on. How is his nose snapped? He was literally just skating that perfectly fine a couple of minutes ago. Also, those guys outside the skate shop are totally sniffing the paint. That cracks me up.
Love you, bro.
Alright, easy, Greg. I want my board right there, that one. Bro, let me get all three of those, actually. Freaking me out, man.
You know, I've always thought that this interaction with Bam was so weird because I feel like pros, when they get skateboards, it just gets sent to their house. Very rarely would they go to a skate shop and just pick up the boards. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I have no idea. I don't know. What do I know, man? I'm just a guy in front of a camera.
For you, I can go that board 140. Tax not included.
$140 for a deck? Without any trucks and wheels and no tax included? Are you kidding me? At most, you're going to see a deck for $65. At most. What do you mean 140? Good lord. You know, every time I see this bail, I always wonder, is this a blooper? Like, this just seems so out of place. It's so weird. Wait a second, Eric. Your board was snapped 30 seconds ago. And here it's perfectly fine. What do you mean? What is the meaning of this continuity, dude? Good lord.
I still can't believe it, man. Bam just walks in and Greg tosses him a handful of his decks.
Come on, you mall grabbers. You know, that's a funny point. Because as a skateboarder, why would I care about the way other people hold their skateboards? You know, I'm just gonna say it. I don't care how you hold your skateboard.
I'm gonna alert the press, man. Dustin's always bailing.
Dude, this guy in the back is having the time of his life, man. Good God. Dude, they got some banger pro skateboarders in this movie. And 10-year-old me was so stoked. Mike V, he's the man. Look at him shred.
Mommy.
That's totally sexual harassment.
They look uncomfortable in their little cages. Come on.
Okay. Yep, even more sexual harassment. Not cool. Okay, Matt, the 30-year-old man just assaulted a child for the skateboard. Also, I'm shocked they're giving away such a bland, nondescript pro model. Usually they give away like a legit pro model with graphics at the bottom. This is just boring. Okay, this scene is actually really special to me because it features Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 4, man, and I love that game. At some point during the scene, Dustin is playing the game and it just freezes out of nowhere. So I thought, is he actually playing the game or is this a video? So I actually reached out to the director of this movie, Casey LaScala, on Instagram, and he actually responded, dude. I asked him, yo, is he playing the game or is he pretending to play the game? And as you can see, he responded and said he was pretending to play the game. Thanks, Casey. You're the man. Go follow him on Instagram and TikTok. He's a cool dude. He also said that Adam Brody, the dude that plays Dustin, called him on the set of Mr. and Mrs. Smith with Brad Pitt and said that Brad Pitt's favorite movie at the time was Grind. A Joey C. exclusive, dude. Like I said, go follow the dude. He's kick-ass, man. Casey LaScala for the win. Thank you for the exclusive, man. Good Lord. Back to the movie.
Hey, man, where's all the money that we're going to use on this chip coming from?
Please stop looking at me.
Dude, you can do this. You have no choice. You're
I
doing
absolutely
it.
Am not doing it. I can't.
Now that the money issue is settled.
I love how they're literally bullying Dustin to pay for this trip. Dude, Eric literally works with Dustin at Chili and such. Why can't he contribute money? If he works with him, he's got the same amount of money he does, dude.
Dude, didn't you graduate like 6 years ago?
Yeah, but they didn't.
Hi.
It's just too easy sitting here year after year watching the new crop roll in.
Yeah, sweet Lou, I love you, man, but times have changed. You can't be saying stuff like that. That is super creepy. Keep it up and see what happens.
Daddy!
What's the first stop?
Ah, that's what you get for being creepy. You get the actor who plays Jason Voorhees in the Friday the 13th movie coming at you with a bat, dude! Good God! Don't be creepy!
Bust you in your grills.
Yeah, in your grills, dog!
I can't believe rewatching this movie as an adult, I'm just now realizing that Aaron McGeehee from Jackass is one of these goons. He's one of four Jackass dudes in this whole movie, the other being Bam Margera. We'll get to the other two later. I'm pretty sure that right there is a shot of the production team during this skating bit. I'm not too sure, but I love Easter eggs when we see production people. It's like seeing something we're not supposed to look at. This is a mistake I have loved since I was younger. Okay, here you see the milkshake being thrown at the van. Then, in this shot, when it's driving away, it's all gone! Movie magic, man! I love it! You know, I can't deny the fact that they really filmed the skating pretty well for this Hollywood movie. And I'm genuinely surprised. And like I said, when I was a kid, I loved this movie. And the skating shots always made me want to go outside and skate.
I dropped something and I'm looking for it.
Egg curly cheese fries. Lots of them.
Okay. Okay, she didn't say anything about puking on them, though.
Ah! Pause it! Look at that! The puke is gone, dude! The kid just puked! Where'd it go? Movie magic.
So listen, I was actually by here about an hour ago. We ordered 10 Gut Bomb chili surprises and 5 shakes. Funny, because when I got home, there were actually only coffees.
Yeah, I remember that order. Drive through and we'll replace it.
Dude, if this actually worked in real life, the people would never go hungry. Like, hey man, I ordered this large amount of food and I didn't get it. Even though the drive-through people literally hand you the food. It's very unlikely. Good God, it's just unrealistic, man.
We have no food and we have no car. Seriously, anyone, what are we gonna do?
Hey, fun fact for you. This road that they're filming in right now is the same road that was featured in the 1931 Dracula movie. It's fantastic.
Look! It's a lizard!
I just got violated by a lizard, man.
Man, I thought this scene was so funny when I was younger, I reenacted it completely when I was 10. Seriously, go look at the clip. I couldn't help but notice there's no beds on this tour bus. I don't know about you, I haven't been on many tour buses, but the ones that I have seen, there have been beds on them. Are they sleeping on the couches, or are they just going to hotels? I don't know, some food for thought, man. Let me know.
Oh, hey, that's a good idea. Why don't you take a crap on his bus? You would appreciate that.
Here's the 3 out of 4 Jackass guys in the movie. Preston Lacey, he plays the guy that has to poop a lot. I never understood this shot at all. Like, it just seems so out of place. Why are we comparing Matt's skateboard to his sister? Is it to show Matt has a spicy picture of his sister on the skateboard? I don't get it.
I love you, Dad.
I got him!
And here we have the 4th and final Jackass member, Wee Man. Who also participates in sexual harassment. Not cool, Wee Man. Not cool. All I'm saying is Eric and Jamie literally met 3 times before this. If that, how are they in love already? It's just silly.
Now I wanna hear it
What always cracked me up about this scene is that they aren't wearing their brand t-shirts and just wearing normal clothes. Usually newbie teams like that will always wear a team shirt. And come to think about it, they've only wore a super duper skate shirt once in the movie, and Eric was the only one who wore it. And being more picky for a second, you can totally tell that that stunt performer is wearing a wig. And honestly, I love mistakes like that. Revealing mistakes is what makes it all warm and fuzzy inside, man. We're not all perfect here, good God.
Yeah, right.
No, sweet losing love. It's crazy, I know.
No. Dude, you met her once before this. Why are you in love already, too? What is with the people in this movie? Good God, you fall in love way too fast, sweet Lou.
Can you talk to Jamie later?
Yeah.
I love how he's just holding a tape measure right now just to hammer down the fact that he works at a hardware store now. That just cracks me up.
Cool, dude.
Hey, man, I saw your demo down in Springfield. You're awesome.
Cool, thanks.
You know, this is something that I just noticed. When he's signing the autograph, he's not actually writing on the board. And you can clearly see that. Also, when he says cool, his lips don't even move. Ladies and gentlemen, non-binary, gender fluid, and everybody else in between, thanks for watching Grind with me. It's a fantastic movie from my childhood, and I really hold it near and dear to my heart. It's universally panned by critics, but fuck them. It's a great movie, and if you like skateboarding and early 2000s culture, it's a great movie to watch. So go watch it, support the cast and crew who made this film, and you know what? You'll have a great time. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching. I greatly appreciate it. Keep your eye out for the next video, episode, movie, live stream, whatever it is, man. Cherish the precious moments, be love, and stay dude. I'm out of there. See you later. Good God.